looking back, I really have not been able to burp once in my entire life. I was noticing it like more and more as I was growing up. Anytime I like ate or drank anything, I just couldn't, you know, release it. It would just kind of have this like weird gurgle sound.
The story of no burp basically happened about 6 or 7 years ago when 30 to 40,000 people found each other on a Reddit page. Basically, there's a constellation of symptoms that patients experience, including inability to belch, increased bloating, flatulence, again, those gurgling noises, pressure in the chest, and they all found each other on this community, essentially. In our experience, we treat a lot of patients with no burp syndrome or retrograde cricopharyngeal dysfunction. The cricopharyngeus is a sphincter muscle between the throat and the esophagus. And at rest, it sits tight and closed. And as we swallow, it relaxes, allowing food to pass through it and into the esophagus, and then it closes up again. Now the reverse is true. It sits tight and air is trying to escape up, but it's not coming out because it's sitting so tight.
Everyone on like TikTok and Reddit was like, this, it's called no burp syndrome. I'd kind of talked to many doctors before and they'd honestly like never heard of it ever. It was just kept like kind of getting worse and worse and just like more prevalent in my life. So I ended up going to a gastroenterologist in New York, and he ended up referring me to Dr. Seth Kaplan here at Lenox Hill Hospital, and he's somebody who actually specializes in it.
Often patients are misdiagnosed with reflux, they're put on different medications, but there are telltale signs. And so with Isabelle, you know, we asked the four questions that help with the diagnosis that includes, have you ever been able to belch in your life? Do you have increased bloating? Do you have increased flatulence related to this? Do you have pressure in your chest, like an air bubble that sits up by your neck, or any gurgling noises? Those are the classic four questions for diagnostic criteria. Other patients have food avoidance, like they'll avoid carbonation related to this. And some patients even have emetophobia, which is a fear of vomiting. What the treatment is we inject Botox into that muscle to weaken it. Botox is a paralytic and it helps weaken muscles. And that's the goal here. To date, nobody really understands the pathophysiology behind why the Botox works in this scenario, although people are starting to theorize. But in a way, we believe that it's a retraining of the muscle, that if we weaken it, even after the Botox wears off in 4 to 6 months, patients are still able to belch. It's almost training the body in terms of like muscle memory to allow for belching. After the Botox, the vast majority are cured with just one injection. There's a small amount of a group of patients that need a second injection, and those have a much higher rate of cure after the second injection. There are further procedures, including a myotomy, where we would actually cut that muscle, but I haven't had to do that on any of my patients to date.
It's just definitely like been very surreal because it was almost so abrupt too. It's like 22 years of burps are now coming out, which is really weird to think about, but it's definitely helped a lot.
What we do is have a post-operative visit about 7 to 10 days after the procedure. I actually asked my patients to bring a can of carbonation, seltzer, soda, something along those lines. I had one patient bring a small bottle of champagne, and they are able to belch. I mean, yes, I go based on history, but it's fun doing it in the office. And I even scope them while doing this. And we can actually see the air coming out of the esophagus. It's this fascinating phenomenon about how all these people found each other when they thought that this was just normal, that this was how everybody was living.
Once you find someone who like specializes it and like knows what it is, it's quite easy to like get diagnosed. It's more just like finding the right person. So thankfully, like I found Dr. Kaplan.